Hi. So in the previous tutorial, we talked about asymptotic notation, the big O, the theta and the omega notations. So now in this tutorial, we are going to take some examples such that we are going to see how to actually find the big O, the theta and the omega notations. So before you watch this video or you take this tutorial, make sure you have already watched the previous one on asymptotic notation, right, where we introduced that concept. So let's go ahead and take some example. But first, what you are going to notice is that when you find the time complexity or the big O and the theta or omega notations, it will be one among these, right? That is 1 log n, n log n square n cube and so on, right? So if it is not among these, then it may be a multiple of these, right? So let's go ahead and take this example, right? Where f of n is equal to 2n squared plus 3n plus 4. And then let's find the big O, omega and the theta notation, right? The big O, that's the upper bound, omega the low, the lower bound, and theta the tie bound, or the average bound. So here 2n squared plus 3n plus 4 is actually less or equal than 9n squared, alright? So from the previous tutorial, remember that you are looking for something like this, where we actually have our k here to be 9 and our g of n to be n squared, right? For all n greater than or equal to 1, right? So if you successfully have something like this for certain value of n, alright, then we are done, and then we can get our f of n is equal to big O of n squared, right? So if you watch the previous tutorial, definitely you should get what you are doing, what's going on here. So 2n squared plus 3n plus 4 is actually greater or equal than 1 times n squared, right? So here we take our k to be 1, and our g of n to be n squared, for all n greater than or equal to 1, then we have f of n is equal to omega of n squared. So first, let me also tell you something, right? So if you take something like this, so instead of this, 9n squared, you put something like 20n squared, right? It's still, it works. So there's no problem with that. But you should take, the closest one, if possible, right? So if you put 1000, somebody is going to ask yourself, why do we take 9? So if you take, if you put something like 1000 here, there's no problem. 1 million, there's no problem, but it's not useful, if you find the one that is closest, the closest one, then that's great, right? So here 9 is we can take 9, right? Even if you take something like n cube, it's still okay, it works. So but it's not useful, even if you take n to the n, right, it's still okay for this upper bound, right? It still works, but this is not useful. So just to enlighten that concept. So now we see that n 1 plus, we can actually do something like this, that is 1n squared is less than or equal to this, that is f of n, which is less than or equal to 9n squared, right? So for the average bound, our k1 is 1, our k2 is 9, then definitely, since we have n squared here and n squared here, right, we take our g of n to be n squared for all n greater than or equal to 1, then our average bound, that is the theta, or the tie bound is theta, which is theta, of n squared, right? So if you have watched the previous tutorial, this, you should be familiar, with some notations here, all right? So let's go ahead and take another example, Let's suppose that f of n is equal to n squared log n plus n, right? So we can do something like this, that is, 1 times n squared log n is actually less or equal than n squared log n plus n, right? You bear with me, that is okay. So and this one, is less than or equal to 10n squared log n, right? So if you successfully do something like this, both sides, then definitely you are done, Now you see that this one, is less than or equal to f of n, So we have then f of n is equal to big O of n squared log n, okay? This one, n squared log n, this our 10 is actually, okay, is the key. So, and here we have f of n, okay, which is greater than this one, right? That means our omega or the lower bound is actually also this one, right? And our k here is 1. So the lower bound is n squared log n, right? So, and this f of n, for the average or tie bound, we have n squared log n, with k1 to be 1 and k2 to be 10, of course. So you see here, we have n squared log n in both sides. That's why theta is actually equal to n squared log n, right? So it's because theta is here, okay? That's our g of n. So let's take another example and try to explain this, okay? So let's assume that f of n is actually equal to n factorial, right? Which is actually equal to n times, right? N minus 1 times n minus 2 times 3 and 2 and 1, right? So you can have something like this, okay? This factorial, we can put here 1, okay? 1 times 1 times 1 times 1, and then in this side, n times n times n times and so on, right? And we can have something like this, okay? 1, this one is actually 1, and then factorial of n, and then here n to the n, right? Then since this one is greater or equal to n squared, then okay, to n factorial, then we can take our f of n to be big O of n to the n, right? So definitely we can take that, and our okay lower bound, that's the omega, to be big O of 1, which is actually a constant, right? It's actually big O of 1. So, and the average or the tie bound doesn't exist, because as you can see in both sides, we don't have okay something here that appears here or something here that appears here in terms of n. So that is the tie bound doesn't exist, okay? If you have watched your previous tutorial, definitely you're going to guess, okay, or you understand what's going on here, since we don't have, okay, because here we are supposed to have some kgn, and here, okay, here k1gn into gn, and here k2 into gn again, but here we have something in terms of n, but in this side we don't have something like that. So definitely the tie bound or the average bound doesn't exist for this function n factorial, okay? So here, of course, you can say that here you can even put something like 2, 5. There's no problem, right? It works. So that's how it is. But you should put something that is useful, okay? The closest one, okay, as you can. So let's just take this fourth example. So here, f of n is equal to log n, okay, factorial, which is actually, okay, if you recall from the previous tutorial, we have something like this, right? We just pass the log in the three sides, and we have something like this, okay? Actually, this one is 0, okay? Log 1 is 0, but don't put 1, bro, don't put 0, right? You should put 1, okay? There's no something, okay, the least should be 1. You should not put something like 0, okay? If you, from this, okay, here you can see that we are starting from 1. You should not put, okay, the time complexity of something to be 0, okay? So always take 1 if you fall, okay, if you get the 0 or something like that. So, and then here we have actually our log of n, okay, factorial, okay? So here is log n factorial, and then which is less or equal than n log n, right? So this means that our f of n is equal to big O of n log n, right? This one. So if we want to put a constant here, it's okay. So and our lower bound is okay omega of 1, and the theta, okay, doesn't exist. That's the tie or the average bound, because if you see here, this one is okay, we have only 1 here, and then this one we have, okay, we have a n something, but we don't have n here, okay? So we cannot conclude on the average bound, right? So I said that here is actually log n factorial, okay? So we should put a factorial here. So, and then that should be all, okay? I hope you got the okay, The concept of asymptotic notation is very important as far as algorithm is concerned. So definitely you should understand this concept, right? See you then in the next tutorial.